hear a lot of bomb craters. It's amazing what one bomb can do. And these are the, I don't know exactly which ones, but these are the ramps where they launched the first cruise missiles in human history, the V1. Verkältungswaffe. So, some more bomb craters. Well, you can make a swimming pool out of it. Big. One bomb. Oh. There's another one. It's full of bomb craters. Whole area here. So this is not far off the coast of France. And there, that's probably the main ramp there. Go and have a look. It looks like a pyramid in the jungle. There's some more. Apparently they had a 1,000 bomber raid here to destroy this one. There's another big hole, probably made by two bombs. Right, here's concrete. That's a big hole. You could dig in here, probably find some stuff. Well, the interesting thing is that all this is in walking distance from the commanderie of the Templars. See what I'm getting at? They know the terrain. They have been coming here for hundreds of years. And, well, I mean, why not put the damn things there where we know the surroundings, you know? So it's another proof about that the Nazis were the Templars, in fact, the Nazi Templars. And they won the war. The Germans didn't. The Germans lost the war, but the Templars won the war. So this is a few hours walk from there. Maybe 1.5 hours, 2 hours. Hi. So, 70 years later. So, you know, this bomb crater here. So, all human intelligence and all their fancy weapons, and they say, well, this is a matter of state security and national security. You're not allowed to come here and put handcuffs on you. Well, in the end, look at it. You can only use it for as a garbage can. Look, this is a garbage can. There it is. There you go. Garbage can. So if it ends up as a garbage can, I mean, what's the use of it, you know? Making such a fuss over all this. What's the use of it? And it's amazing how just one bomb can lift up and take away like two truckloads full of earth and pebbles and stone and rocks and just in a second. Yeah. Wow. Well, let's have a look at that pyramid in there, or whatever it is. It's probably the... Oh, there's some nasty weather coming up. I think I've blown my tongue. So here you can see this is the ramp of a V1, a cruise missile launching ramp. So this is the launching ramp of a V1. Heading for England. So that must be the probably the coastal line there. Looks from far away, it looks like being in Mexico seeing a pyramid. Oh, you don't have to go to Mexico, I showed you've got them in France as well. So let's have a closer look here. Vergeltungswaffe. Was denn für eine Vergeltung? Wegen was? Because of what? I just put down my pack. You can see the whole area is plowed with bomb holes, bomb craters, all over. It's all plowed. Yeah. Looks like pre-Columbian, Inca style. Let's have a look here. That's horrible. This is, I'm on the launching ramp of a V1. There's England. Ah ja, Engländer. Engländer, ja. Da kommt es, ja. There we come, eh, with your the bigger bomber, yes. Well, maybe not so funny. From the other side. Well, I'm gonna crash here somewhere, put my tent here. Let's hope there's no bombing raids tonight. Here's the other side. Nicely camouflaged by NATO after 70 years. Maybe archaeologists will say, like, in 1,000 years, after the 1,000-year Reich, well, what was this? What did they try to build here? Was it a pyramid or the beginning of it? And they didn't have any more stones for it. Bad weather coming up. Living quarters, probably. It's a bit near, though. Machine gun turrets, more garbage cans. There's that thing there. There's probably a lot of, a couple of them here. Another garbage can. Yeah. Hey, silly humanity, hey? Remember, you know, all the wars you want to do, you're gonna die. Switzerland's going to be rich. and the pharaohs will and the templars will have more power, and they're not going to die. Only you won't see your children, and it means a war against the enemy within, I guess, eh? But, well, humanity is too stupid to understand that. Oh, it starts raining. Looks like a toilet. Oh, it doesn't look that stable. Well, of course, it's a whole complex for an important site like this. For the national security. Yeah. We are so important, you know. Well, it's just a whole lot of garbage cans left. Well, there's another one. So, there's my tent. It's getting dark. It's 5:30. There's the Scud launcher, the V1 launcher. There's this. So, sleeping just next to it. National security. I'm defended by the machine gun turret here. Hope to do a good job tonight. Yeah. There's the garbage can there, one of them, where the lads can throw the garbage in there. Yeah. Or like dump the bodies in there. Yeah. Oh, wait. There again. Some more bunkers. V1 launcher. Night's coming up. Some more bunkers. And there's me. Oh. Ooh, there's a fallen tree there. It doesn't look nice. I hope that's the only one. I did have a look here. There's no branches overhead. Ah, moon is there. I did have a look. Only this tree looks a bit dead, but on top there are leaves, you know, so won't be that bad. There are no dead branches overhead. It's always dead branches first that fall, and then there's just one trunk. It falls in the end. So, well, let's pray. Good night. The inside of this machine gun turret here. Looking at my tent. That looks like a cannon shell there. Let's have a look. Hope it won't explode. Oh, there it is. It looks like part of a chimney or something. Try to stick it up here. It looks more genuine. There you go, that looks real. The only problem is it's pointing directly at my tent. Slight problem there. Probably still some dead bodies, guns and everything underneath. When it all got bombed by an air raid here. So I'm here in the middle of the V2 ramps, a launching site here. Now what this is, top holes. I should have, because you can hear the storm, because of the storm, I should have put my tent here. But only this tree is hanging over it, you know, you never know what happens. And it is catching wind up there. Oh. So this is in the V2, V1 launching site. Yeah. Weird, eh? In France, just next to the channel, next to Calais, not very far. And that's me. They wouldn't have thought that like 70 years later, South African would sleep here, would they now? Weird, eh? Sometimes you should just wait a little bit and everything will be all right. Just wait 5 years and then the war is over and, you know, continue your life. People thought it would be forever, what lasted 5 years, to just hit away. There's always an end to anything, everything. It's a bit stormy. I hope nothing like this will happen this night. Or I was a bit afraid last night. Look. Wham. Stupid human race, you know. I'm glad I'm a deserter. I mean, because all these stupid wars we have to do for the fair aristocracy and the Templars, who are fair aristocracy as well. It has nothing to do with an honest war for your country or some nationalist idea. It's crime. Shooting missiles at innocent people, children, their homes. This is crime. And there's no shame in it to desert a thing like this. I'm not afraid. I can fight if I want, you know, if it's like for defending whatever I love. But this is crime. Has nothing to do with an honest war. There are no honest wars anymore. There haven't been any for a long time. So they have four wings at least. They got the religious wing, the Vatican and all that, you know, to occupy our minds and to steer us where the control center is, to make us believe, you know, that we should turn the other cheek and, oh, at all costs, not stand up and not defend yourself. Just as the rabbi said, you know, well, God will protect you from Hitler. Well, he was not there for the for 10 years, or was it from 12 years. He was not there. God was on a holiday. Then there is the military wing, the Templars. Out of the Templars came the Freemasons. That's their political wing. They're there for the lies, the cheating, the false images, the false proofs, weapons of mass destruction. We have to save Jerusalem and Jesus and his grandmother from the terrible people there. Well, the only goal was robbing the, well, it was their own stuff, the pyramid. So they were the grave robbers, the Templars. And then we have their financial wing, the Swiss banks. And Octagon, their bases. I can distinguish at least four wings.
And none of these stupid Germanic or European soldiers had any idea what was really going on. Don't do it. Don't do their wars. Let's fight the enemy within. And I'm there to help you. So you can do this. And all this, you know, become a man. Well, at least what you think, they were scared anyway. All shit scared. Or you can also do that, become a man, being alone, have nothing to eat, solitude, a warrior's initiation, and wait until you are like between 50 and 60, you've had your life, and then get square with the bastards. These bastards, who would have sent you into the war at an age of 18? At an age you don't want to die. At a juicy age. You want to have a juicy lady. And later on, because you love her, you want to have some kids. It's against nature to die at that age. But it's not against nature, and also for the sake and the love of your kids, and our prosperity and the human race, you know, to give you a life later on, you know, to give it back to them, everything you have accumulated. Dying at 18 is not natural, and you don't want to die, you know. Only some sickos might do so, who are unhappy anyway, who don't understand life anyway. So wait until you're a bit older. Live first. Swallow it up. You know, resist in another way. And then wait. Give it back to them. The enemy of mankind. The pharistocracy. The pharaohs. Who became the aristocracy, the old world order. And who are now the new world order. And it's no use, you know, organizing anything, you know, more than with four people, like, because they infiltrate everything and you'll lose. Apparently they tried to kill Hitler July the 20th, but they're all betrayed by von Stauffenberg and all the nobility, the same aristocracy who led you into the war. You get betrayed anyway, so just organize with a few people and get square with them. Everything out, you gotta accumulate it up by them. Got my point? Right. I'm not doing this for my own glory, you know, it's all here. I would prefer to be with my kids, but I'm living in hell, a true hell, in Switzerland, Octagon, the heart of evil. So I have to get out sometimes. And I'm doing this for my kids and for all you. I gain nothing with it. The only thing I gain is hunger, cold, tired, pain in my back, carrying all that shit, being on the lowest of the ladder, asking people for a ride, asking for something to eat. I don't even want to ask anymore, you know, so I don't eat like for 2 or 3 days. I don't do this for my own glory, understand? I do other things, speak French, speak German, I speak English, even Swiss, German. I have a real good job. But, so I gain nothing. It's for the future, for our future. Some of you might understand, most of you don't. Well, there's my gun barrel.